four centuries ago, John Napier of Merkeston, from whom this university proudly takes its name, invented logarithms, one of the greatest contributions to the advancement of knowledge. It was a great step which underpinned Kepler's work on the orbits of the planets and Newton's theory of gravity. Today you, Edinburgh Napier University's most recent graduates, take your own next step. History records the support and encouragement to work and study that John Napier received through his faith, from his family and friends, and from those who read his work. We share today's joy with those who have helped us reach this step. And so I invite you to begin today's ceremony with a moment's reflection to give thanks for the support we have received and the strength we have been given by others. I declare our ceremony now open. I'm not here to lecture you today. You're probably sick of that. I'm here to confer upon you your degree and wish you well. I'm also here to offer some advice for what it's worth. If someone ever tells you your dreams are impossible, wish them well and tell them perhaps theirs are, but not yours. The reality is, none of us know what tomorrow holds. What I can tell you for sure is you'll never achieve any dreams if you don't try. Dreams are important, but no more so than the journey in search of them. In terms of physical miles, I grew up not too far from here. In terms of me ever thinking one day I'd be privileged to stand before you on this stage, well, that was another world away, and a dream I could never have imagined. We never cease to learn, so long as our minds and hearts are open, and often our classrooms of tomorrow have no walls. I like to tell the story someone unknown taught me. A few years ago, when I was walking down 10th Avenue in New York, and I passed a construction site, I noticed a little scribble, a piece of graffiti on a temporary wall. I can't credit the author's wisdom as they chose to remain anonymous, and whilst I've adapted their scribble to suit my purpose today, I hope I do so with their blessing, and I believe we have similar hopes. I've added the word dreams along the word success here. This is what most folk hope for, but here's the reality. That made me smile, but also made me think. If the scribble on the left was the reality, I think it would disappoint most of you, not immediately, but eventually. Hard to believe? Well, let me tell you why. The little bundle of chaos on the right, the confusing bit, well, that's where the magic really happens. That's the part of the journey in front of you that most of you can't even begin to imagine today. But funnily, it's the most important part of the journey. It looks confusing and chaotic, and often it is. But don't fear it or never underestimate its value, for it houses a special part of the journey that lies before you. It's important because it's where you'll find your wildest dreams, the ones you can't even begin to imagine today. And take my word, they're even better than the ones you can. Please try to remember this when all seems lost, and from time to time it will. But never stop trying, for it will unravel itself one day, of that I'm sure. I'm also sure, well, I hope so, that you all want to go congratulate one another, share some smiles, a couple of selfies and a few drinks, and for me to keep this speech as short as possible. But please take one extra little moment today and think of all the people in this world and the dreams so many of them imagine. For many millions, their dreams would be to sit on the very seats you're sitting on today, in anticipation of what you're about to receive. For some folk, they can only ever dream of education, and sitting where you are at this very moment in time, enjoy and cherish this very moment. Today is about you, tomorrow even more so. Today is the start of what is a relatively short journey, so don't waste your time worrying or being fearful of failure. Only fear not trying. Failure can often be the greatest contributor to a person's success, and never stop dreaming. And I hope along this road, you like me one day experience your wildest dreams. I stand here humbled and proud before each and every single one of you as testament to their existence. Share your moments and encourage others to dream. Who knows, one of you as testament to their existence. Share your moments, encourage others to dream. Who knows where they may become part of your dreams. My hopes are not for you to change the world. The world will take care of itself. My hopes are for you to respect it, enrich it, and support it. Experience will feed you like little else you'll encounter. Share experience and wisdom with others. Enjoy this day, and to each and every single one of you, congratulations and well done. I now introduce the conferment of the Honorary Award.
Chancellor, it is my privilege to present David Lanc for the honorary degree of Doctor of Enterprise. Computer security is one of the key challenges within computing, and without it, our digital economy will not have a solid foundation, and thus we are in serious danger of destabilization. Over the years, David has played a key role in innovation in the finance sector and rolling out innovative cybersecurity products. Currently, David is the founder and CEO of Payfont Limited, a next-generation cybersecurity company which innovates and transforms today's linear space into a completely dynamic cybersecurity protection, rendering people, organizations, and data safe. Payfont's IP is patented in the US and has been validated by top cybersecurity professionals and finance professionals as transforming security online. A chartered accountant with a joint degree in accountancy and computer science, as well as a PhD in business technology strategy transformation, David made is an entrepreneur with rare skills. He devised and introduced several world-first innovations throughout his career, building a national and an international reputation for innovation. Previously an executive director at RBS Cards, David led its global strategy, payments innovation, and analytics. He led the acquisitions of WorldPay and Link, delivering credible international payments business for RBS. He was the first person to introduce 3D Secure for internet payments in 2003 and was an influential member of the UK committee that oversaw the UK rollout of the EMV chip and PIN. David is no stranger to startups, having previously been the chief operating officer of a New York-based internet business and the CEO of his own software business. His industry profile includes pivotal positions on the UK chip and PIN EMV national rollout, membership of the Visa Europe Advisory Board for Product Innovation, as well as the CREST Professional Investor Group for UK securities dematerialization. David completed his self-funded PhD in business technology strategy in 2006. He's a published speaker in business technology strategy, alignment, data management, and business transformation. David left the world of banking to concentrate on innovating in the world of online and e-commerce security. He has invested his own wealth and raised over $1.675 million to fund Payfont, with a single focus of making people, organizations, and data privacy safe online for everyone. Prior to entrepreneurial life, David was responsible for leading significant aspects of the successful RBS NatWest integration. He also led the merger of the integration of Scottish Widows and Lloyds TSB, and with the strategy of the merged businesses. Currently, David has worked with the Cyber Academy at Edinburgh Napier University and has closely collaborated on advanced cryptography methods which protect data within a cloud-based system, and which has been rated at the highest level possible by independent patent assessors. The work undertaken in collaboration with the university has since been built at scale within Payfont, considerably enhancing the valuation of the company, along with the development of application areas within healthcare and in the finance industry. One thing that I say to all international students here is that we prize your background. David's background is his father is Polish and his mother is from West Berlin. This shows the commitment made by the city and the university to embracing all from around the world. Thank you. Chancellor, in recognition of his major contribution to innovation and entrepreneurship, I invite you to confer David Lanc the honorary degree of Doctor of Enterprise. Thank you.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, academic staff, family and friends. Good morning, fellow graduands, to whom I offer my congratulations on your achievements and importantly your own personal life journey to get here. My gratitude to Professor Buchanan, Bill, for his humbling oration, and obviously to Edinburgh Napier University for conferring my award. Now, I thought originally this was going to come at the end of the ceremony, so I actually stand between you and almost everything, so I'll be brief. I'm not going to bore you with tales of woe, I'm not going to make any political sentences, because that's just nonsense. But I want to share with you some facts of life, and some facts that should make you proud to be here, not just because you've achieved something, but because you're here. Life doesn't owe you anything, Chancellor just said that. It doesn't automatically put you at the head of the line to greatness just because you're sitting here. Now that would be great if that was the case. So what does your award actually mean? It means we're recognized for applying the talent we have and the education we're given by these people behind me who dedicate their lives to giving you that education to achieve something that's worthy. That makes you different. It gives meaning to your life. So as you sit there, think about it and humor me. Just look to the person on either side of you. Go on, look, they're people, and smile. You have reason to smile because you've all achieved something that very few in the world ever will. And you've got the rest of your lives to build on it. Now, that's the best chance you're ever going to get. But it's also your obligation, because that's the obligation we inherit from a Scottish culture which spans hundreds of years of world-leading education, learning, and innovation, and the commerce that follows that innovation to bring us great innovation. Because creating real enterprise is about dedication to a cause that's worthy. God, you thought it ended now. No, it doesn't. It continues. It has to be worthy of your talents, of your focus, and of your obligation to make the world better in the way that you can. It's your chance to make a difference. As the Chancellor said, you know, the only fear you should have is the fear of not trying, because failure isn't something that's necessarily a bad thing, it's a learning thing. Now I'm going to end with 10 short facts. A lot of you would have put the lights on this morning as you went to the toilet, okay? You would have ate perhaps toasted bread or maybe got milk from a fridge for your cereal or your coffee or your tea. You'd have watched the TV. You'd have probably played with your mobile phone while watching TV. You may be used to pedaling your bicycle around Edinburgh, and your loved ones may have got here through using an aeroplane or a train. And at some stage today, you'll have lots of colour photos taken of yourself. 10 reasons to say thanks to someone who benefited from Scottish education, turned that education with their talent into enterprise for inventions we couldn't live without today. In that sense, wherever you come from, we're all slightly Scottish. And that's a fact we should be proud of. Thank you.
I'm now delighted to introduce the musical interlude performed by our music students. Beat Not So Hard My Heart, written for soprano and ensemble. The music is by Kenneth Dempster, words by Jenga Saner. The aria was composed in 2004 to mark the 70th birthday of Honorary Doctorate Sir Peter Maxwell Davies, who sadly passed away in March of this year.
Miles east from south return you. Chancellor. I am pleased to present students for the following awards. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a programme of work entitled Appropriating Interaction, Thomas Edmund Flint. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a programme of work entitled Towards an Emotionally Intelligent Interaction Strategy for Multimodal Embodied Conversational Agents Acting as Companions, Maria Elena Roa Gonzalez. For the award of a Doctor of Philosophy for a programme of work entitled Participation Space Studies, a Socio-Technical Exploration of Activist and Community Groups' Use of Online and Offline Spaces to Support Their Work, Ella Helen Taylor-Smith. Chancellor, I'm pleased to present students from the School of Computing. Willem Nana, Chris Hesse. Haytham Mohammed Ahmed Ali. Fawaz Al-Ruwali. Jerry Bartley. Ramiz Qureshi. Ajahn Thankachan. Connor Tuffy. Bree Friel. Avril Susan Rosie. Winner of the University Medal, Ailey Walker. Wasif Ali. Thomas Costan. Andrew Robert Neal. Aina Pankuli. Kayvon Arabshahi. Martin Joseph Shaw. Caroline White Amito. Christopher Cameron. Peter Abbey. Daniel Barry Brown. Winner of the Payfont Prize for Innovation, Stuart Edward John Duncan. Fraser McIntosh. Jordan Ross. Adam Thompson. Clement Oustrier. Laura Nicole Phillips. Cosmin Ross. James Howard. Alexander Bates. Winner of the University Medal, Paul Ronald Burridge. Hanan Pervez. Gregor Stefan Zukrik. Winner of the School of Computing Award for Best Knowledge Transfer Related Project, winner of the University Medal, Stuart William Byers. Liam McNeil. Winner of the University Medal, Megan Thomas Gussie. Louise Chalmers. Callum Wilson Kerr. Rudel Hawk. Matthew Gowden. Winner of the University Medal, winner of the O'Reilly Prize, Craig James Thompson. Robert Wierzuski. Stuart Dick. Martin George Lowe. Marius Prokop. Lewis John Roger. Mario Vinilov Stekov. Matthew Stephen Tate. David Josh Wright. Jitender Bhandari. Simon Collier. Jamie Charles Rutherford. Dale William Wright. Morgan Stewart. Laura Elizabeth Elliott. Winner of the University Medal, Piotr Bielanowski. Nevena Etimova. Winner of the University Medal, Mark Abbey Lockhart. Magdalena Masternak. Winner of the University Medal, Ethna Barry. Akin Bawali, Akin Kumni, Anguda. Carrie Leanne Boardman. David William Fullerton. Philip Kuati Congo. Gerald McManus. Wilma Purser. Helen Robertson. Sharmila Sheikh. Malvina Thompson. Winner of the University Medal, Max Robert Mackenzie Atkinson. Winner of the University Medal, Graham John Neville. Graham David Walters. Christopher Johnston Downey. Brett Whitley Hamilton. Ioannis Karakanis. Adio Stephen Ojo. Ryan Glass. Kenny Lawrence Banjo. Vanessa Burke. Philip Menken. Omar Ali Ahmed. Ron Jake Hangdog Lacaspi. Leonid Laren. Colin Brett McKinnon. Elaine Valerie Myers. Paul Peter Thurer. Winner of the University Medal, William Kerr. David William Cochran. Andrew Gardner. Winner of the British Computer Society Prize, Callum Gathergood. Winner of the Lawrence Ho Student Prize, winner of the University Medal, Rafal Sarnowski. Magdalena Wozniak. Stephen Hardy Colgan. Callum Andrew McCall Farrell. George Mason. Callum Neil Fisher. Lauren Rebecca Hall. Monica Ivanova. Christopher John Milne. Tamas Arpadi. Winner of the University Medal, winner of the Lawrence Ho Student Prize, Todor Stefanov Rusinov. James Beattie. Nicole Clark. Graham Stewart Duncan. Nicolaj Sebastian Jedoriskas. Sorry. Laura McLeod. Robin Marshall. Kathleen Lara Ramsey. Winner of the O'Reilly Prize for Digital Media, Louise Traberg Nielsen. Laura Williams. Stephen Wilson. Nikki Alexander. Patrick Baleva. Scott Burgoyne. Cameron Boyd Garner. Jonathan McMahon. Warren Taylor. Rebecca Mary Yoon. Magnus Joss. Conal Morrison. Sandy Spence. Winner of the University Medal, Jakob Tansey. Llewellyn Bailey. Megan Rose Carlin. Jeremy Jusso. Liam Gordon Lynch. Winner of the University Medal, Sam Serrells. Connor Alexander Black. Neil Notman. Andrew Fotheringham. Stephen Anderson. Chris Bobby. David James Sandilands. Winner of the Lawrence Ho Student Prize, Agnieszka Banach. Shika Haridas. Angelika Ladupina. Winner of the University Medal, winner of the School of Computing Award for Best Research-Related Student Project, Chloe Sanderson. Ryan Cooper. David Telfer. Roderick Gillis. Donald Henderson. Kevin Hone. Nicola Kane. Shirley Jane McCulloch. Mary Richmond. Winner of the University Medal, Robbie McLean. Martin Fragg Whittenstall. Euan Corney. Amir Iftikhar. Lewis Sharp. Callum James Beck. Patrick Glasgow Kelly. Kevin Reid. Winner of the University Medal, James Michael Sharkey. Liam John Arthur Bell. Ali Hassan. Aaron Stevenson. Christopher Robbie Barclay Kellis. Craig Vincent Aspel. Roberto Francesco La Greca. Finlay Smith. Jordan Paul Moffat. Nikki Keegan Scott. Beza Shahid. Winner of the University Medal, Dulce Amelia Dos Reis Mendes. Flavia Tabita Chiolaca. Winner of the University Medal, Christopher George Laidler. Stuart McCallum. Sam Barker. James Denham. Graham Fennell. Fergus Kelso McGill. Christopher Morris. Kevin Nisbet. Adam McLeod Pusty. Robert Gordon Denham Stewart. Joanna Zacharias. Winner of the University Medal, Rachel Sarah Davies. William Stuart Bell. Alan Robert Boyd. Helen Wynne Hall. Richard Mulholland. Catherine Louise Padfield. Winner of the Deason Prize, Bartosz Borowski. Winner of the University Medal, Jason Dang. Declan Kay. Mark James Murray. Daniel Early. Colin Fong. Alexandra Mary Kane. David Nicol. Jordan Sanchez. Winner of the University Medal, Nicholas Charles Hunt. Chancellor, I now call upon the Assistant Principal Student Experience to present students from the School of Engineering and the Built Environment.
Chancellor, I am pleased to present students for the following awards. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a programme of work entitled A Framework for Improvement of Contractor Selection Procedures and Major Construction Project in Libya, Othman Elsea. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a programme of work entitled Photogrammetric and Stereovision Techniques for Evaluating Material Properties in Timber and Timber-based Composite Structures, Ahmed Mohammed. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a programme of work entitled Automating Condition Monitoring of Vegetation on Railway Track Beds and Embankments, Roger Gauthier-Nyberg. For the award of Doctor of Philosophy for a programme of work entitled Developing Whole Life Cost Models for Retrofit Options in Office Buildings, Olubukulu Ulumiwaya Tokedi. Chancellor, I am pleased to present students from the School of Engineering and the Built Environment. Winner of the University Medal, Andreo Spadaro. Aaron Kalias. Winner of the University Medal, Yvonne Segura Jaquez. James Smeaton. Ryan Mitchell. Michael McGillis. Kirsty Allen. Karina Astrid Bagarinu. Winner of the University Medal, Sophia Victoria Alexander Brunius. Mark Coyne. Winner of the Chartered Institute of Architectural Technologists Prize, Callum Mulhern. Christopher Aitchison. Sean Barton Ducasse. James Conley. Greg Coyle. Joseph Eric Dean. Taylor Louise Dickinson. Scott Harkins. Peter Edward Morton Kelly. Craig Ian McIntosh. Stephen John Patterson. Kirsty Scott. Nicola Morna Hannah Taylor. Pauline Alistair. Polina Kazmerzak. Scott Ramage. Piers Tebbutt. Hannah Melissa Trestrail. Matthew David Wilson. Emilio Santino Marcantonio. Blaine Davidson McManus. Akinlulu AI. Jane Joss Bass Hapuli. Osama Muhammad Ali Zawawi. Kevin Coburn. Winner of the University Medal, James William Towers. Kieran Derek Boner. Car Fay Stephen Chi. Stephen Greg Fraser. Luke Thomas Howie. Fiacra Lindsay. Daniel James Manson. Baldev Singh Rihal. Winner of the ACOM Prize, Nicola Wright. Sean Hayden. Leo Frederick Walden. Freddie Brasted Watts. Laura Cunningham. Winner of the Jacobs Dissertation Prize, Callum Struan Sharp. Rory Allen Vernon. Isaac Kawadu Andu Kesson. Anna Cervantes Ora. Joe Harwood Durham. Christian Hulsberg. Benjamin Jenkins. Christopher Leeson. Lewis Wilson. Babuka Elesh. Colin Rosie. Connor Scott Aitken. Ibisam Ahmed Ali. Driton Barami. Winner of the Jonathan Clark and Dunn Building and Civil Engineering Prize, winner of the University Medal, Greg Gibson. Winner of the Institute of Civil Engineers Prize, Dale Johnson. Cameron Christie. Daniel Paul Sewell. Winner of the Scottish Timber Trade Association Prize, Thomas Edmund Jacques Deveux. Winner of the Jacobs Honour Project Prize, Stephen Coron. Brody Railton Sharif. Winner of the CIOB Construction Project Management Prize, winner of the Adam Curry Medal, winner of the University Medal, Daniel Lewis McMillan. George Alexander Brown. John Campbell. Ian Hyatt. Kieran Ross McFarlane. Gregor James Scott. Scott Andrew McDermott. Joshua Ogunuru Egbiroa. Mufuta Eyanwele Fakunelli. Martin Jamie Houston. Winner of the University Medal, Victoria Jane Herbert. Ross Robert Muir. Callum Caird. Stuart Duncan Gow. Mutu Basavaguda. A.M. Mohammed. Barath Kumar Munigauda. Dimitrios Kolosov. Winner of the University Medal, Matthew Robert Grain. Angelos Konstantopoulos. Stefan McCosh. Christopher James Owens. Simon Hall. Christopher Scott McCall. Ewan Thomas. Gerald David McCormack. Winner of the University Medal, Stephen William Taylor. Patrick Carl Günther Schiebel. Florian Karl Unseld. Winner of the University Medal, Marius Tim Velk. Winner of the University Medal, Mark Ferguson. Christopher John Bradby. Emily Mullen. Winner of the University Medal, Christian Jan Skutcha. Daryl Jordan Spittle. Daniel Alistair Blythe. Remy Chatting. Benjamin Hamilton. Michael Martin McLeod. Lewis Marison. Nicholas Morell. Cody O'Neill. Gary Thomas Ormiston. Clement Rult. Euan Watson. Ricard Badiabach. Colin Blake. Quentin Jean Copan. Michael Alan Johnson. Alan Methven. Madalina Gabriela Popa. Fabian Dario Hofstetter. Patrick Husser. Olubukulu Uluwatuan Adibeo. Venkateshwaran Dayelan. Carlos Villanueva Prondes. Benjamin Anthony Love. Amy Sarah Balfour. Fraser Alexander Coburn. Stephen Craig. Georgia Louise Grimmer. Alistair Lynn. John Severin. Winner of the Institute of Engineering and Technology Prize, winner of the University Medal, Alan Lewis Speed. Gary Thompson. Winner of the University Medal, Itu Alexanteri Vilan. Callum Warnock. Ryan William Fennec. Andrew Fitzgerald. Scott Forrett. James William Gell. Stefan John Halliday Christopoulos. Samuel David Hutton. Angus David Bruce Keller. Robert Andrew Kamuri. Stephen Maxwell. Andrew William McCrickrick. Greg Neary. Craig Ronald Nicholson. Benjamin Roland Reed. Igor Tetter. Philip Peter Todd. Hassan Ahmed. Colin Curry. Cameron Diel. Michael Donoghue. Hassan Javed Iqbal. Siwar Mubarki. Alexander McCartney. Christian Mazaros. Rory Mitchell. Andrew James Parker Hoare. Akil Pathros Prince. James Samuel Stewart. Mark McKenzie. Greg Winter. Simran Singh. Timothy Joshua Graham. Winner of the University Medal, Bandar Mohammed Alhari. Euan Bond Camlin. Sven Mayer. Lisa Ann Simpson. Winner of the Ian MacLeod Memorial Prize, winner of the University Medal, Lars McNeil Tom. Marike Bies Lasko. James Gompertz. Dominique Herbstritt. Rory Horsburgh. Matthias Philip. Neve Richardson. Elliot Thompson. Linda Jane McGregor. Winner of the Elsevier Built Environment Prize, winner of the Murray and Curry Property Development and Valuation Prize, winner of the University Medal, Connor Andrew Scott. Thea Justin Davis. Winner of the Elsevier Built Environment Prize, Nicholas Richard Hay. David Victor Ishak. Winner of the Society of Construction and Quantity Surveyors Prize, winner of the University Medal, Stuart Andrew McIntosh. Ian Ronald Park. Winner of the ACOM Prize, winner of the Doig and Smith Prize, Marcella Taylor Cooney. Scott McCallum Gardner. Craig Hepburn. Gregor Liddell. Osman Malik. Craig Mitchell. Afnan Akram. Amy Kinmond. Ricardo de Popris. Mano Subramaya Pila. Kishore Kumar Tirumarela. Simeon Emmanuel Eaton. Richard Hernan. Ian Barry Kirkellis. Gavin Sheriff. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of students from the School of Engineering in the Built Environment.
Can I ask the graduates to please stand? By the powers vested in me by the University Court and the Academic Board of Edinburgh Napier University, I confer the awards for which you have been presented today. For those eligible for an award but unable to attend today's ceremony, I am pleased to confer the awards in absentia. Many congratulations to you all Please be seated.
Good afternoon, Chancellor, Court, Vice Chancellor, Academic Board, guests, ladies and gentlemen, graduates. A very warm welcome to you all. I'm very honored to be here, able to share this incredible experience with you all today as your ENSAR student president. The ceremony marks a huge achievement and milestone in your lives. And you should all be really so proud of where you are today. All of you here today probably started on this journey in a different many ways from all over the world and different various backgrounds. Studying at Edinburgh Napier University means you are a part of community and family. Edinburgh Napier University and ENSAR are proud to be a home to such a diverse culture of students with passion and great ambition and determination. Dear graduates, remember, education is a key, knowledge is a power. So you all have done your very best for your future path. Today, you have reached the finish line and you have walked across the stage to a future you have built and worked for. Once again, we are all so proud of your achievement. I want to take time to thank some remarkable people who have there to support you every step of the way. We all have that one member of staff who we know has gone above and beyond for us, who has inspired us, and who is the reason we are here today. I would like us to share our appreciation for all the academic staff at Edinburgh Napier University, who have worked so hard to give you the best learning experience possible. Again, so please join me again, give you a huge round of applause for teaching staff at Edinburgh University. Furthermore, I also want to show our appreciation for hundreds of staff who don't stand in lecture hall but are still just as important our educational journey. We also owe our thanks to all the staffs from school office, study skills, student hub, IT staff, accommodation, career, your ENSA, library, cleaners, and porters who are so important. There is also senior management at Edinburgh Napier who all make this possible, all the deans, directors, principal, and the university leadership team. Please, let's give you a massive round of applause for all the staff at Edinburgh Napier University. Dear graduates, opportunity will never come to you. You have to create a platform for it. So the more you try, the more you push, the more you work hard, the more you challenge, you will reach your goal. If you say you can't do, then you can't do. If you say I can do, then you can do. Because the motivator inside you, no outside. Finally, it is time for you to face the big challenge of the world, and you should be so proud of all your achievement. And remember, you will always have a home here at Edinburgh Napier University. Dear graduates, remember this as well. You are the captains of our creative industry, engineers, tomorrow company directors, parliamentarians, leaders in innovation and education. Go forward and carry the name of Edinburgh Napier and raise it higher. I wish you all the very best and congratulations to the class of 2016.
I'd like to add my welcome to that of David, our Chancellor, and to that of Rojan, our President of ENSA. Welcome to our newest graduates, and also welcome to alumni and to families, friends, and well-wishers who are all here on this very special day. And graduation day is a special event in the Edinburgh Napier calendar. Indeed, for me and for all the staff of the university, it is the highlight of our year. And although we attend many graduation ceremonies, be assured that each one is unique and special for us. And so my very, very warm congratulations to each of you, our new graduates. This day of celebration is undoubtedly about you as we toast and applaud your success. I also want to recognize those here today supporting you, your families, your friends. All of us knows that, you know, to arrive today, it's not a solo effort. My son graduated quite recently, and what an emotional day it was. I felt pride at his achievement. I wanted the day to go on forever. It was so special. And perhaps I felt a little bit of excitement mixed with apprehension about what was to happen next and how his future would be. I also want to add my thanks to that of Rojan's, to the staff of the university, many of who are here today, but many who could not be with us. It's very hard to actually sum up their feelings, but just let me say, I know that they are as proud as bunch of you. I was reflecting over the last few days on my own graduation ceremony, and while I was remembering and reliving that sense of occasion, I cannot actually remember who spoke or what was said, which is not very encouraging when I'm here giving you an address this morning. But in that knowledge, I will be brief, and I hope, if not the words, but the essence of what I say will remain with you for just a little while when you leave the hall today. And the essence of what I say is rooted in the role that I believe universities play in shaping societies. 3 years ago, just before I took on the role of principal of this wonderful university, I considered this quite deeply. I have since led Edinburgh Napier University on the basis that universities, which have a key role in creating knowledge and educating individuals, are fundamentally important to developing in their graduates what the John Henry Newman, who wrote about the ideal of a university two centuries ago described, developing the general powers of the mind. Universities and their graduates are a force for social cohesion, prosperity, and well-being. And we are gathered here today at a time when we have never needed universities and their graduates more, for much is at stake. From the many comments from pundits in media worldwide, to the very conversations in our own homes between families and friends, we ask ourselves, what is going on? What is happening in the world? The tumultuous state of UK politics at this time, our new journey as the UK voted to leave the European Union, and one without an obvious destination, terrible wars in the Middle East, climate-related famine in Africa, a refugee crisis in Europe, terrorists performing chilling acts of brutality and exploiting new media to spread fear. It is somewhat bewildering. So these are remarkable and challenging times. And the connectivity of people around the world means we are living through crisis in our living rooms on almost a daily basis. Now, none of us knows what the future may bring, but we absolutely need our adaptable, resilient, thoughtful individuals who have been developed to think creative and critically, to challenge the status quo, and to be imaginative. People who use evidence, reason, facts, and logic to formulate their views and to shape their actions. These are the general powers of the mind that Newman talked about over 200 years ago. And to me, they remain the bedrock of education in university. Here in Edinburgh Napier University, we maintain an unwavering commitment and dedication to educating our students in an environment where ideas thrive and new knowledge and advances are made through rigorous testing, challenge, critical evaluation, and debate. As an outward-looking university, We are a vital player in a global system which is increasingly driven by knowledge, innovation, and ideas. And we are a force for good. Together, university communities around the world have reached across borders and nations to tackle challenges. We have unlocked and harnessed new knowledge to change the way we communicate, and we have helped heal divisions and foster understanding through dialogue and debate. Such is the power and role of universities in our time. And you, our newest graduates, are well equipped to shape the future. And my challenge to you today is this: to use all that you have gained throughout your university journey to make a difference to the communities in which you will live and work. You cannot control the nature of the world you will face, but you can control the attitude you bring to that world. Be courageous, be imaginative, as in many ways in your time here you have demonstrated. Take, for example, the computing students who traveled to China to develop an app to make group project work easier across international boundaries. Think of the students that use virtual reality technology to bring brutalist architecture in Bulgaria alive for a 21st century audience. Think of the civil and transportation engineering student team who answered the call to help replace track at the Bowness and Kinneil Heritage Railway. With such talent, the world is undoubtedly at your feet. Many of you here today have come to Scotland from around the world, including many from the European Union countries. I am proud of the talent and diversity that you bring to our community. You have enriched us. For Edinburgh Napier University is a community of learning with a goal of personal and social as well as intellectual development. Bringing students of diverse backgrounds to learn from one another enacts that commitment. In a world seemingly divided by difference, here in Edinburgh Napier University, we strive hard to be united by it. And as this university looks to the future, we will continue to grow our international reach to seek out and welcome students and staff from around the world who share our values to join us in our journey. And to all graduates, be in no doubt, as you have benefited from your time here with us, so you have made this university a better place. Because you came here with unique qualities of your own, and as you learned from us, so we have learned from you. You leave us equipped with skills and attributes, with the general powers of the mind, and I hope with a sense of responsibility and a strong desire to make a positive impact. I am excited by all that you have to offer. I know I speak for all the staff when I say that we are proud to have you as our graduates. I hope that you feel a strong attachment for the university and to the city of Edinburgh. Please tell us about your progress, for your success is our success. And take pride in our achievements too. Speak with others about your time with us, but most of all, be a part of our future by staying connected as valued alumni. Finally, when looking for that unique graduation card for my son, I did note one that said, "May each day be worthy of a story." And this is what I wish for each of you, that your career is fulfilling, rewarding, and touched with some adventure too. Graduates of 2016, my warm congratulations, all the very best.
The next part's not scripted, and this is part of hate. Basically, to follow on what the principal was saying there is, you are now part of a larger family. A family that the faces may change on this stage over the decades, but the principles and the hopes of this university never will, or hopefully never will. You have gifted us and trusted us with some of the most precious years of your life, and sincerely and heartfelt, this university thanks you for that trust. We hope you go forward tomorrow and make the world a better place. I now declare this graduation ceremony closed. Please be upstanding for the academic procession.